Many people know and love Marshawn Lynch. He's played for countless teams and been a dominant force on the football field for many years. He's also everybody's favorite celebrity off the field, known for being down to earth and unchanged by NFL fame and glory. Lynch has towed the line of being soft-spoken and bold perfectly throughout his career, while also making defensive players suffer for over a decade in the NFL. But who is Marshawn Lynch? Today, we'll show you the true origins of Beast Mode. Born in Oakland, California, to a family of four siblings, Marshawn Sapp Lynch was raised in a separated home. His father had spent most of Marshawn's life in a jail cell. Many of Marshawn's youth coaches believe that his fragmented parental upbringing is what fueled him to run so angrily. At 12 years old, his mother, Delisa, would give him Skittles before the game, which she called power pellets. After every touchdown, you could see her giving Marshawn a handful of Skittles to eat. He continued to do this his entire career, but more on that later on. Marshawn attended Oakland Technical High School, where he was a four-sport athlete. A star in football and track, Marshawn ran for over 2,000 yards and 33 touchdowns in just 10 games in his senior season, while running under 11 seconds in the 100-meter dash. Ranked the second-highest running back in the nation coming out of high school, Money Marshawn had a lot of choices. Recruited by the prestigious USC and UCLA, along with every other Pac-12 school, Marshawn decided to do his own thing and commit to Cal Berkeley. Marshawn's strained relationships with his father led to him dropping the Sap in his name, and he just became Marshawn Lynch that we know and love today. Not many people predicted Marshawn would go to Cal Berkeley, but a lot more people predicted he couldn't make it through the quote-unquote smart school. Luckily, Lynch has always bounced to the beat of his own drum, and that's what has made him one of the most lovable characters in football. At Cal, Lynch dominated from the first snap, with 800 yards and 10 touchdowns in his freshman season. In his sophomore season, it was clear that Lynch was special. Amassing over 1,300 yards and another 10 touchdowns, even though he missed two games for an injury. But it was during his junior season that Lynch had his national coming out party. Lynch plowed through the Pac-12 with over 1,700 yards and 15 touchdowns. In a huge rivalry game in Washington, Lynch scored the game-winning score in overtime. He then proceeded to jump on an injury cart and drive it across the field, inciting the crowd into a frenzy. Lynch finished up the second all-time rusher in Cal history and locked himself into an early draft pick. Because of this, Marshawn decided to forego his senior year and enter the NFL draft. Marshawn Lynch was drafted with the 12th overall pick in the 2007 draft by the Buffalo Bills. Lynch immediately accepted to Buffalo culture and became an instant fan favorite. Lynch had made the all-rookie team with over 1,000 yards and 7 touchdowns. He followed up that impressive campaign with another 1,000-yard season and his first Pro Bowl selection. Unfortunately, he was not a fan favorite of the law and the NFL head office. Lynch was arrested for illegal possession of a firearm in his home state of California following the 2008 season, and NFL commissioner Roger Goodell suspended him for 3 games. He lost the trust of his coaching staff and his starting job to Fred Jackson. Lynch saw his role and his production diminish. It was clear his time with Buffalo was nearly up. Lynch had serious potential, but also needed to mature. This led to the Seahawks trading draft picks for Marshawn mid-season to bolster their running attack. Marshawn has always been known for his scorned running style, finishing every run with ferocity, fighting for every yard, and dragging defenders on his back into the end zone. Seattle quickly took to Marshawn like their own son, affectionately naming him Beast Mode. Lynch was seen on the sidelines of a game still eating Skittles after every hard-fought touchdown, and it didn't take long until the 12th man began to shower Beast Mode and Skittles throughout the game. In Lynch's first playoff game ever, he created the most defining moment of his career. Tied late in a game, Seattle were huge underdogs to the visiting New Orleans Saints. Then the Beast Quake happened. Lynch darted through the line of scrimmage, breaking 3 tackles in the first few yards. He quickly shed Jabari Greer before Tracy Porter got near. Marshawn disposed of Porter, chucking him away with a vicious stiff arm that sent Porter flying. He was in the open field now, where another tackle tackler attempted to bring him to the ground, he bounced off the tackle with ease. Lynch broke so many tackles that Porter had the opportunity to try again, of which he slowed up and respectfully declined. 9 broken tackles later, Lynch cut across the field and launched into the end zone backwards, taunting the entire Saints defense. The crowd reaction was so loud, it shook the stadium and registered seismic activity. Seattle completed the huge upset, and Lynch was immediately immortalized. In his first full season, Lynch was selected to the Pro Bowl with 1,200 rushing yards and 13 touchdowns. In 2012, Seattle and Lynch began to hit their prime. Lynch had a career-high 1,600 yards, but 2013 was his true banner year. Behind an all-time defense and the consistent dynamic running game of Lynch, the Seahawks dominated opponents left and right, winning the NFC Championship and getting a shot at the Super Bowl. Lynch spearheaded their offense, rushing for 13 more touchdowns. His bruising style of play wore out opposing defenses, while Seattle's defense suffocated their offense. This led to huge fourth quarter runs and blowouts along the way. In the Super Bowl, Seattle and Lynch destroyed the Broncos to win their first Super Bowl in franchise history. Along the run to the Super Bowl, Lynch's distaste for the media became a huge storyline. This enamored fans with Lynch even more, who would regularly be short with his responses to post-game questions. At times, he even refused to give a response, saying yes or thank you. Rebellious behavior against doing something he had to brought him many fans. Seahawks fans fundraised enough money to pay for his accrued fines. He chose to give that to a charity, then went on to get even more fines for his media relations. Seattle looked to repeat as champions in the 2014 season, winning the NFC title once more. During Super Bowl Media Week, Lynch walked up to the mic and said, "I'm just here so I won't get fined," to every question he was asked. This blew up into a huge meme, and Lynch's rebellion and enigma-like personality further gravitated his following. In Super Bowl 49, Seattle looked to repeat as champions against the New England Patriots. After an entertaining back-and-forth matchup, New England took a 4-point lead late in the game. On the ensuing drive, Seattle drove all the way down to the 1-yard line, with seconds remaining. Instead of handing off to Marshawn Lynch, Seattle elected to pass the ball. The ball was intercepted on the goal line, and just hand the ball off became a huge docking point for head coach Pete Carroll. This moment caused a rift in the Seahawks organization. Just 1 year removed from the Super Bowl, Marshawn struggled through a slew of injuries. He missed a playoff game in 2015, while his backup began to excel. On the day of Super Bowl 50, Marshawn Lynch unexpectedly announced his retirement. Lynch retired at the age of 28, having reached the pinnacle. Always quiet to not let people know his move, Marshawn is unpredictable and captivating. Following his retirement, he went on a slew of media and business ventures that he wanted to do. During this time, he became a mentor for young kids in Oakland and athletes at Cal Berkeley. Most stories would end here. Lynch had won a Super Bowl, been an All-Pro and a Pro Bowler, created one of the most famous plays of the 21st century while still retiring at a prime age. In a truest form of loyalty and fulfilling boyhood dreams, Lynch came out of retirement to play for his hometown, Oakland Raiders. After missing the 2016 season, Lynch returned in silver and black, refreshed. He added on another 1,000 yards to his career totals and was a leader for many young NFL players. In the final game in the Oakland Coliseum, Lynch lit up a celebratory smoke in Al Davis's eternal flame. Lynch was Oakland through and through. And with the Raiders leaving Oakland, Lynch retired for the final time in 2019. His career was full of measurable accolades and championships, but we will remember Marshawn Lynch for the moments, amazing and irreverent. There will never be another beast mode. So let's all be happy he was just here so he doesn't get fined. What was your favorite Marshawn Lynch moment? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching Nonstop Sports. We'll catch you next time.